answer is up to you.
Amen.
The Bible says, Paul said, when I was a child, I behaved like a child. He was an adult. He can be an adult in the presence of God and act like a kid. And he can be a kid in the presence of act like an adult. Paul said, when I was a child, I behaved like a child. I think like a child. I function like a child. But because children don't pay bills, children don't know how to pay bills, they eat and fall asleep. That's all they know. They eat and fall asleep. Children cannot pay bills. Only mom and daddy can pay bills. But if you are here, life is not fair. And we are living in a world where people are killing themselves. We are living in a world where things evil are praised. Evil are praised. But as a light of honor, we have to rise up in the name of Jesus. Lift your hand. Come on. Lift your hand. Close your eyes. I need a good attitude tonight. I need a good attitude. Somebody, you need a healing tonight. Yes. You need a prayer tonight.
Yes.
We don't want to be selfish believers that think about ourselves. Somebody's dying. Somebody's sick. But as you stand here in the presence of God, we can command change in the city. We can make a difference in our generation. Is anyone hearing me? It's a night of answer. Spirit, Yahweh, 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 Kusete, Prarato, Rahitate. Somebody lift your hand tonight. Tonight is a night of answer. Are you hearing me? I don't know why you're here, but I know I'm here. I serve a living God. Whatever he said, he will do it. Whatever he said, he will do it tonight. He said, you are hearing me. Clap your hand and pray God just for a few minutes. Open up your mind. Clap your hand. Pray. Pray. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
Agree with you
to boost your confidence
because
I serve a living God. said, never, I serve a living God. Say, I don't serve a dead God. I serve a big God. I serve a God that came out of the grave. I serve a God that is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. I serve a God that can't celebrate his birthday. Are you hearing me? I serve a God that lives beyond time, beyond eternity. I serve a God that holds the whole universe on the palm of his hand. Is anyone hearing me? I serve a God that can never worry. I serve a God that can never know how to sleep. I serve a God that can never be tired. Tonight, it doesn't matter what you're going through, shake your neighbor and say, tonight. I said tonight. Now hold that person. Let's lift your hand. Father, we thank you tonight.
Amen.
We give you all the glory. That in your presence there is fullness of joy.
Amen.
Father, we just want to forget about all the business of this world.
Amen.
We cancel every distraction tonight.
Amen.
We arrest every thought of void, every voice of doubt,
Amen.
Every voice of unbelief,
Amen.
Every worldly voice in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want to hear a good amen.
Amen.
I want your amen become louder than your liver.
Amen.
Yeah, you got it. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We don't serve a dead God. We serve a living God. So tonight, lift your hand and say tonight.
Tonight.
My prayer has been answered.
My prayer has been answered.
Who believe that?
Hallelujah.
Who believe your prayer has been answered?
Hallelujah.
I can't hear somebody. Who believe it? Somebody say it's a night of answer.
It's a night of answer.
And what did he get?
Answer.
Where are you?
Answer.
You're gonna be a living
answer
after tonight. Focus on the voice of God. And I believe your life will never be the same again. Just lift your hand and say, Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Have your way.
Have your way.
Amen.
Amen.
So Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
I refuse
to be
a teenager
in the presence
of the Lord. Say I am matured.
So
use me in this last day
to change
my generation. Say I believe
I'm here
on assignment.
Say
I'm here
for a reason.
Say I am valuable.
I am important.
I am somebody.
Say
my heavenly Father. Place your hand on your head. Say touch me today.
Touch me today.
Say touch me right now.
Touch me right now.
Say I froze my mind.
I froze my mind
to the voice of the Holy Spirit.
The voice of
say I believe. Jesus,
love me
too much.
So
I will live
and testify
the goodness
of the Lord.
So after tonight. Say
after tonight.
Say I refuse
to be
ashamed
of the gospel.
So every chihuahua
in my life,
either they stay
or they hear the gospel
by fire.
By force.
Say, I refuse
to compromise
the word of God
anymore.
Because of tonight.
Fire.
Fire.
Will be infused
in my spirit.
Say,
I'm gonna walk out of this place. A living, moving, talking fire. I can never be afraid.
I can never be ashamed.
Because
greater lives.
Right inside me.
I believe that.
Today,
the doctor report
will be changed.
Today,
the bank account report
will be changed.
Today,
your school report
will be changed.
Today,
the history of your family
will be changed.
Today,
somebody
need a pay rise.
Somebody
need a business.
Somebody
need the fruit of the womb.
Somebody
need marriage.
Say,
my heavenly Father,
we are here.
We expect that all things
are possible
with you.
We believe it.
We receive it.
We catalampanite.
We catch it. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus.
Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Can you say a good amen?
Amen.
Can you say a wonderful amen?
Amen.
Tonight is not a night just for confession. Tonight is a night of war session. Tell me, say war session. The Bible said the kingdom of God is not in word, but in power. And Paul said we are not fighting against flesh and blood. The devil doesn't know what excuse me is. He doesn't know what sorry is. He doesn't know what apologizing is. The devil needs to be dealt with. Are you hearing me? The root cause of cancer is the enemy. The root cause of divorce, separation, whatever you're going through today, the root cause is the enemy. God is good.
All the time.
God is good.
All the time.
Is your life good all the time? Get the reality and then we check it. Is your life good all the time? No. Sometimes today, Sunday, stomach, pregnancy loss, many things going on. And the Bible shows us God is good. Now who is responsible for that? So tonight we're going to find out who is responsible and we'll put him in his place. Are you hearing me, somebody? Because if you don't do anything about it, nobody will do anything about it. Are you hearing you? There's some things nobody can do for you. That's why prayer is very necessary. The reason why people don't go to prayer in other churches, they don't know what prayer is. Prayer is necessity for living. Without prayer, you die like a chicken.
Come on.
And we see believers dying like chickens. And they're waiting upon the Lord. No! He don't wait upon the Lord. God waiting upon you. God lives in you. Are you hearing me? So we are waiting upon who? Where is God? So where is the mouth of God? It's your mouth. God is waiting for you to open up your mouth. So tonight, it's a night we don't want to die like chicken. Are you hearing me? I can't afford to be wasted because I have the answer. The answer lives in me. How can you be the headmaster and fail your own subjects? How can you be the principal of the school and mark your own subjects? Is you. You are the headmaster. You're the one that gave the test. What can you say 100%? The headmaster failed in his school. The headmaster fell in his school. Who marked the result? The headmaster. Who checked the result? The headmaster. Who fails people? The headmaster. The headmaster failed. Error. Terrible error. You need to be corrected to that. And the Bible said, Enoch, you know the word, and if you go to Genesis, let's go to Genesis first, Genesis chapter 5, verse 21. The Bible said, Enoch, someone said, Enoch. The Bible said, Enoch walked with God. Enoch walked with God, and he was no more. Enoch was so, had a relationship with God, he tapped into the supernatural without knowing. He disappeared. He catapulted from the realm of the physical realm to the spiritual realm. The Bible, the word Enoch means experienced. Did you hear that?
Yes, sir.
His name means what?
Experienced.
He has an experience with God. His name means experience. The reason why we give up, we never have an experience. When you have an experience with Jehovah, you can't give up. Are you hearing me? So tonight, you're going to have what Oracle experience. See, your word can't keep you. The Bible can't keep you. What can I keep you is your experience. Where you encounter your God. Are you hearing me? Where you encounter your God, he can go back to you and say, see what the Lord has done. The Bible says, Enoch walked with God. And his name means what? Experience. I hear. And the Bible says, verse 21 says what? Please, first. Help me, please. Shepherd.
Enoch lived 65 years.
Yes, sir.
And begot Methuselah.
Methuselah, would you know what the word Methuselah means? Means what? Ever. It means long life. So the moment you walk with God, the result is
long life. Thank you.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And he did that.
Yes, sir.
He had an experience, and he gave birth, and the one he gave birth is long life. Can you lift your hand? You can't die before your time.
Amen.
You didn't hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
I'm here as a prophet, you know. Are you hearing me? Lift your right hand. I prophesy to anyone watching tonight.
Amen.
Tonight is going to be an end of your suffering.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Yes. Say, I will live.
I
can't hear you.
I
can't hear you.
Say,
I will live.
I will live.
Because I'm praying. I don't know why I see in the hospital. You. I see in the hospital. Yeah, but God going to hear him tonight.
No way.
Sit down. Sit down. Lift your right hand. Maku septa praha. Maku de praha. The power will say, Enoch walk with God. And he give birth to long life. Experience give birth to long life. He can give birth to long life in your families, your business, your marriage. Can you lift your right hand today? I say you can give birth to marriage, a long marriage, a business, a career. But not just give birth, but long
life.
That's why we say end up walk with God. Experience give birth to long life. Nobody with that like chicken in lot of knowledge.
Amen.
There's a place in the Bible. There's three people that God spoke to angel before their birth. Somebody like Abraham. Abraham, God said, through you and your seed, which is Isaac, all the nation of the earth shall be blessed. Right? And then another person, Samson, his mom, have an encounter with an angel. Angel said, Reza can never touch his head. You're gonna be special, you're gonna be a Nazarite. We learned it last week, right? Which means set apart for God to be used, right?
Yes.
And another man we talk about is John the Baptist. But I'm troubled about John the Baptist. That's the place we're gonna base in and we're gonna begin to pray. I'm troubled about John the Baptist because Jesus says no prophet is greater than John the Baptist. John the Baptist was a great man, but he died like a chicken. Greatness, but died. Like nobody. A man, Jesus actually mourned about him. In other words, Jesus was not happy about the death of John the Baptist. Because if he was happy, why should he mourn about John the Baptist? He said, nobody was greatest like John the Baptist. Are you hearing me? John the Baptist is a man, when Jesus, he was the one that baptized Jesus Christ. But he never socialized in the world. You didn't hear that? He was isolated from the word of God. The word of God was alive. He knew the word of God, but he never hung out with the word of God. That's what happened when a man or woman became a born again, baptized, he never hung out with the word. He became isolated by the word. You cannot live without the word. Are you hearing me? John the Baptist never hung out with the word. He never hung out with the word of God. He's a prophet. He's a great man, but he never read the word. Empowerment class, they don't. Church service, they don't. If you don't have time with the word. Okay, let's go. Are you ready to lunch?
Yes,
I feel like something has come upon me now.
Yes,
you are greater. Okay, let's go. Matthew chapter 14, verse 6. Matthew, the book of Matthew.
But when Herod's birthday was celebrated,
yes, sir,
the daughter of Herodias danced before them and pleased Herod.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, he promised with an oath to give her whatever she might ask.
Whatever she might ask. Continue, please.
So she, having been prompted by her mother, yes, said, give me John the Baptist's head here on a platter.
Do you hear that? Somebody's prayer point is your head. Why you are playing around? Why John the Baptist was not focused on the word? Somebody want the head of the John the Baptist. You are not different from John the Baptist. Are you hearing me?
You are not hearing me today.
Yes, sir.
I say, are you hearing me?
Yes,
somebody prayer request is the head of John the Baptist. You didn't hear that? Somebody prayer request, if you are watching tonight, somebody prayer request is the head of who? John the Baptist. Now the person that requested the head may be physical, but it's a demon. Because behind the lady is a demon. People don't eat head. People don't eat human head. Do you eat in New Zealand?
No way.
In Samoa?
No.
Not yet? Oh, you don't do that. Are you here? But somebody said, give me that head on the tray. Hello? Somebody's head on the tray. is somebody heard. Can you lift your right hand? While you are sitting down, that's why you have to be serious with God. Are you hearing me? Whether you're a girl, whether you're a man, whether you're an adult, whether you're a kid, you are most wanted by the enemy. He wants to destroy your family. He wants to destroy your finances. He wants to destroy your health. He wants to destroy your business. While you are playing around, the enemy is in your head. But I'm here to tell you, nobody will take your head. Nobody will take your head. Say, nobody will take my head. Nobody will take my head. My financial head. My business head. My marriage head. My children head. Clap your hand. Say, nobody will take my head. Open up your mouth and pray. Come on. In the mighty name of Jesus. And then the Bible says what?
And the king was sorry. Nevertheless, because of the oaths and because of those who sat with him, he commanded it to be given to her. So he sent and had John beheaded in prison. And his head was brought on a platter and given to the girl. And she brought it to her mother.
She fulfilled her assignment. John Hill was beheaded. The greatest man, one of the great, he's not one of the great, he was the greatest prophet. A greater prophet can be beheaded. Because why? He was isolated from the world. He never socialized with the world. He never participated with the world. He know better than the pastor. He know better than everybody. He know it all. He knows. Number two, he was discouraged. He was expecting Jesus to act like him. He was in jail. He was expecting Jesus to visit him. So he was looking for, is any, he's the one that baptized Jesus, and he's the one that asks, are you Jesus, or do you have to look another Jesus? You don't need to isolate yourself. Number two, you can't be discouraged. We are in the prison worship, they are just passing past. You're in the usher team, they are bad. Everybody's bad apart from you. And when you do that, your head is wanted. I'm telling you. Even when you were doing that, your head was wanted. Your head may not be physically. Maybe your marriage. Maybe your business. Maybe your career. Maybe your talent. Maybe the things that God has blessed you. Head is something that makes the body move. Head is not just only your head. Are you hearing me? Head, what? See, he can cut the one of this leg, I can still move. He can cut one of these arms, I can still move. He can cut my ear or whatever, I can still move. But when you chop the head off, the life is over. The enemy is not about your finger, it's not about your leg, it's about your head. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me, somebody? But you have to become smart enough to say, I can't be in church politics. I want to know him. I want to know the King of glory. I want to know everlasting Father. His name is the Lord of Lords, the King of kings. He saved me from doing. Are you hearing me, somebody? The Bible says John was put in prison. John never do anything about it. What is prison? Prison is, you used to pray, you're not praying now. You are in prison. You used to read the Bible, you're not doing it. You're just, oh, I just take it slowly. You are in prison. John, why can't he get out of himself in prison? He was in prison. He may be in prison through the word of God. The prayer, the church things he used to do, he don't do it anymore. The things that cause you to be hunger for God, to win soul, even to give. He don't even tithe anymore. Because the pastor taking your money. But the money does not belong to you. We don't have nothing. We are caretaker of God's possession. Nobody here has money. Everything belongs to God. Either you believe God or you believe yourself. You can't serve yourself. You must believe the word. So you stop your own place and then you are in prison. Before you are in prison, you get beheaded. A great man of God, a prophet, evangelist, a pastor, a bishop. The devil doesn't care about your title. The devil care about the world. Tell the devil, doesn't care about how smart, how nice makeup you put on. He doesn't care about your high heel. doesn't care about your jacket. He cares about the word of God. Lift your right hand. Say enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
No, say enough is enough.
Enough is enough.
So that must be a difference.
There must be a difference
between a Christian,
and a religious person.
Between a born again,
and
an unbeliever. Say tonight,
I refuse
to allow my family,
my
finances,
my finance,
my career,
my business,
my talent, to be beheaded by the enemy. Clap your hand up. Clap your hand up. Come on. That's why we are here. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now lift your right hand. Tonight is a night of answer. Magubra hasita. Branduke sebra hasiti. Mando braha. Rekasuto braha. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Hosea. Hosea chapter 4, chapter 12, verse 13.
By a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt, and by a prophet, he was preserved.
Then we are preserved. Do you have another translation, please?
The Lord used the prophet to bring Israel up from Egypt. By a prophet, he cared for them.
Do you have another one, please?
Then by a prophet, the Lord brought Jacob's descendants out of Egypt.
And then?
And by that prophet, they were protected.
Tonight, you're going to come out of Egypt. By the word of a prophet.
Yes.
Do you believe the word of God? Lift your hand. I want a good amen.
Amen.
I said, I want a good amen.
Amen.
Now, Egypt is financial trouble.
Uh-huh.
Egypt is your visa.
Uh-huh.
Egypt is your marriage.
Yes.
Anything that trouble you, God brought them Egypt. Yes. But the Lord said, God brought them out by the prophet. How? By the mouth of the prophet.
Yes.
When I decree and declare today, are you hearing me? When I decree and declare by the power of God, the angels of God, the angels of miracle, the angels of healing, the angels of breakthrough, that I go to your home, your body, your marriage, your business, and whatever that's not God, will catch fire. Is anyone here? Amen. Tonight, somebody say fire.
Fire!
By the word of the prophet, he brought them out. And by the word of the prophet, that we are protected. Are you hearing me today? If I decree that by power, by fire, you can never touch by disease, it shall be so.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, Lord. The problem now is, can you believe the word? That's it. If I decree, within 3 days, residency, visa, job, be released, it shall be so. Is anyone hearing me? It's a night of answer. Are you hearing me, somebody? Are you hearing me? Is anything to go, to be for God? Is anything to have for God? To clap your hands and say, the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. Good night. We are not here to preach. We are here to cause chain loose, bondage loose, prison scatter, prison back off, poverty yeah. Pray for me. My path to blow up. I hear it. Enough is enough. It's about the word of the prophets that we are. And by the word of the prophet, that we are preserved, careful, protected. So protected. So after today, you're going to be brought out.
Amen.
And then you're going to be protected. Listen, the devil will come back down to check. Oh, the fence is still high.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Tell them, after today, you're going to frustrate the enemy.
So
you're going to become trouble to your trouble. So you're going to become pain to your pain. Lift your hands. After today, I'm going back home. I am bad. I tell the devil, I am bad. You can't depress. oppress me anymore. You can't oppress me anymore. You can't allow haters to stop you. You can't allow police to stop you. He said, in the name of Jesus, if God is for me, who can be against me? I don't serve a dead God. I serve a living God. Power is in my mouth. Victory is in my mouth. Breakthrough is in my mouth. Somebody say, hey, hey, hey. Yes, by the word of the prophet. Now we are preserved. Amen. The angels of the Lord. Just lift up your hand to the Lord. Jesus, you love me too much.
Saliva gonna be coming out. Are you hearing me?
Tell your neighbor that I can't eat. Is there anyone here that can eat food on behalf of somebody? Is anyone here that can eat food on behalf of somebody? You and your husband are?
One.
Hello. Who you and your husband are?
One.
Whatever the Lord has judged, let no man separate because they are?
One.
Can you eat food on behalf of your husband?
No.
Why not? You are one. The man will die. I'm telling the man will die. Say, darling, don't eat. I'm eating on your behalf, okay? For 1 week. What are you talking about? Say, we are one. The Bible says we are one. I got somebody say, pray for us. Pray for you. Pray for you. Nobody can eat food on your behalf. That's on this. Nobody can do for you. Only you. And that's why the day you are saved, God didn't save you a cat or a dog. God saved you alone. God didn't say, confess with the cat, the Lord Jesus. Or confess with your wife, the Lord Jesus. If you. So that's on this you have to do. Tonight is you. Tell your neighbor, it's you.
It's you.
If you're going to open that mouth proper. Don't worry about your neighbor. Don't worry about anybody, brothers and sisters. There's nobody to see. When you come to Jesus, nobody exists. Nobody can compare with my heavenly Father. Are you hearing me? The people that say, I got your back, they don't know you. When you're in jail, they back off. Yeah. They don't have your back. They just noise. I was in a funeral with one day. The man said, man, I love my wife so much. There are elderly people. I can't live without her. I can't live without her. The lady passed away. I said, can you join the 30 years? No. What do you mean? I thought that you can't live with that. Come on, go inside. Then so that everything can be easier. Say, I can live with that. Tell them all you see.
All you see.
It's not all there is.
Make
sure you take advantage of it. Don't believe at all. Go your back, but they ask stupid and go to jail. They walk away. They don't have your back. They criticize you. Men are weird. God is the same. Are you hearing?
Yes.
So when we are praying, jumping, no more just thinking what we're doing, because we don't do that in power. We don't are stupid. We are people that pray. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
We use our mouth for the right things.
Amen.
We use our body for the right things.
Amen.
We don't use our body for the things of the world. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Even though that's not Jesus, to use my body for the things of his filthy stuff. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
It's yak stuff.
Yeah.
But when you become a born again, you are peculiar.
Yes.
Are you here? You are fearful and wonderful man. You are a special breed. When you come to the presence of God, you say, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Let them love you. When you employ them, they will love you and you will employ them. God will make sure they are broke. Don't worry about them. Until God will make sure that you become someone and you give them a job and then you give them pay rise in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? Tell them, say anybody that wants your head tonight.
Anybody that wants your
head. We eat their own head. That's our prayer point number. Anybody that wants your marriage, we eat their own head.
Amen.
Don't want your head on a plate, they eat their own on plate. In Jesus' name. The Bible says what first?
Now about that time, Herod the king stretched out his hand.
It's a spirit, it's not a person, it's a spirit. Stretch forth his hand, what?
To harass some from the church.
Harass some from the church, yeah, come on, come on. Yeah.
Then he killed James.
He killed James. Someone said James is killed.
James is killed.
I can't hear you.
James is killed.
He killed what?
James.
He killed the families. He killed what? The marriage. He killed what? The business. He kills what? Your prayer life. Your spiritual life. You are compromising now. The word of God is not exciting anymore. If you want to read the word of God, 5 minutes, watching TV, eating Baba, yes Baba. You can stay on that program for 20 hours. Eating chicken, yes Baba. Watch. Wait, did they pray for me? You can stay on that Baba stuff for 20 hours and be happy. Telling lies, no Baba. You stay here for 2 hours. I'm smiling. Look at you. I can see your face. I want to see your face. I want to know your ways. I want to find your ways. Okay, that one. Yes, see, the word of God, they can't. Now, Baba has talked 2 hours. The Bible became a sleeping pill. Like when you're, oh, Father, Lord Jesus, God, understand. I read in the spirit. Which spirit? Don't do that. Killed. James has been killed. Tell them, James has been killed.
James has been killed.
When that happened, know that James has been killed. When your husband and your wife begin to sleep with the word of God, tell you, hey, James is about to kill. Wake up. James has been killed. The Bible said he killed James. Yes?
The brother of John with this word.
Yes, sir.
And because he saw that he pleased the Jews.
Oh, when the devil takes this away from you, he pleased all the little demons. The little demons, yeah. He says she's a Christian. He says he's a Christian. Look at her. She's complaining all the time. Look at her. My life is nobody. I'm going nowhere. Demon, Jehovah, demon said, yeah. Look at her voice. The Bible said, he saw that he pleased the little demons. The little demons are happy. Look at the way she talk. She said, I'm nobody. Yeah. Can you sit here? Auckland demon come. Cratchit demon, Ashbottom demon, they all come. They're looking at you. They say, I don't know where is God. I don't know where is God. Does God love me? Does he love me? Does he love me? Where am I here? My life is boring. What are you doing? Tell them, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
Your life is powerful life. You are a born again. You are fearful and wonderful made. Made in the image of God. And then Bible says what?
He proceeded further to seize Peter also.
Oh! He killed James and all the demons are having party. And the Bible says he set forth his hand again and arrested what? Peter. Tell them about Peter.
Peter.
Peter is different. Say them about Peter.
Peter.
He can eat the head of Peter. He can eat the head of James though, but not Peter. Peter is a strong man. I'm Makush Abraham. If your name is Peter here, we're gonna make you tonight to become Peter. In Jesus' name.
Now it was during the days of unleavened bread.
Yes, sir.
So when he had arrested him, he put him in prison and delivered him to 4 squads of soldiers to keep him, intending to bring him before the people after Passover.
See how the enemy arrived? He made sure you are surrounded by what's up. For how many squads of soldiers?
4.
One is what's up. One is Facebook. One is what?
Twitter.
And one is Instagram. And then you are surrounded by them. Busy man. You have no time for the world. You have no time for anything. You are surrounded by what's up. Everything. Distraction all around you. These are soldiers. They are soldiers. They are there to kill. Are you hearing me? Well, let's know how to turn that what's up off. Say, don't what's up me at this moment. Don't Facebook me at this moment. Don't Insta. What do you call it? Yeah. That's it. Yeah. Yeah, at this moment, imagine that they were surrounded. Tell them, you don't need a soldier. The soldier is already here. WhatsApp is a soldier. Facebook is a soldier. All this social media is a soldier. If you don't control it, they will kill you.
Peter was therefore kept in prison, but constant prayer.
But what happened? The church prayed.
Constant.
The church prayed.
But constant prayer was offered to God for him by the church.
By the church. They didn't pray when Peter was arrested, when James was arrested. But when Peter was arrested, the church prayed. It didn't say a person prayed. The church prayed. Church, can we pray tonight?
Yes, we can.
Lift your letter, can we pray?
Yes, we
who
can.
Who prayed for the Peter?
The church.
I can't hear you.
The church.
Who prayed for Peter?
The church.
When we're talking about church, we're talking about the whole body of Christ.
Yes.
We are talking about the prayer of unity.
Amen.
We are talking about the congregation stand in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
One voice, one mouth, one leg, one teeth. When we say, hey, we are here not to anything. We are here to make sure that Peter come out of
prison right now. Are you hearing me? And the Bible said, what happened? Say, in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Say, Peter has to come out tonight.
Peter has to come out.
By fire, by force.
By fire, by force.
Now, you know what your Peter is. Your Peter may be your finance. Your Peter may be your business or your children. Or your But when Peter was arrested, the church prayed earnestly for Peter. Lift up your hand. Say, every spirit that is responsible
for my setback,
delay, deny,
failure,
whatever that's not from God.
In the name of Jesus,
I command you, catch fire. Come on. And by the word of the prophet, they were delivered. And by the word of the prophet, they were preserved.
Amen.
Just lift your hand. Especially for this nation of New Zealand. We're going to declare no more disaster, no more earthquake, no more. Are you getting me? The Church of Jesus, we are the light of the city. We're going to declare no more disaster in the name of Jesus. We're going to now see what Jesus is going to do tonight. Jeremiah 33, say what? Jeremiah 33, verse 3. Please help me, our boss.
Go to me and I will answer you. And show you great and mighty things which you do not know.
He said, I will show you great and mighty things which you do not know. He said, when you call, he will show. Someone said, call. And he will show. But tonight, it's not God showing you. Tonight, you are the show.
I receive it.
And then he says, John chapter 14, verse 20. Please.
At that day, you will know that I am in
with that day. At that day, with day, say tonight.
Tonight.
Tell them, he said, talking about tonight. Now, lift your right hand. Tonight.
Tonight.
I said tonight.
Tonight.
And then what will happen? You will know that what? I am
in my Father.
And then?
And you are in me.
Uh-huh.
And I in you.
Hey! I said, hey! I am in my Father. You are in me. I am. In you. Hey, 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 hey. I am in my Father. You are in me. I am in you. I am in my Father. You are in me. I am in you. In other words, we are the same.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And then verse 21 says what?
He who has my commandment.
Now, the commandment, I am in my Father. My Father, you are in me, and I am in you. If you have that, what's going to happen to you? And keep it. And believe it.
Yes.
What's going to happen?
It is he who loves me. and he who loves me will be loved by my Father.
And yes. I will manifest.
Yes.
In other words, you became the show.
Hallelujah.
Now, if God is manifesting, who is manifesting? If God is manifest, who is manifest?
Amen.
Where is God?
Amen.
Where did he manifest?
Amen.
Where did he smile?
Amen.
Where did he jump?
Amen.
Are you hearing me, somebody? Clap your hand. Clap your hand. I said, clap your hand. Somebody said, hey. Now Jeremiah said, come unto me. I will show you. But in our generation, he doesn't show us. We begin the show. So now, where is the answer?
Amen.
Who is the answer?
Amen.
Say, I am the answer.
Tell
your neighbor your name for tonight's answer. No question. You are the answer. Lift your right hand. Can I prophesy to you? Your residence have you released. Your citizenship have you released. Your job have you released. Your marriage have you released. Your career has been released. Your business have you released. Can you receive it? Can you receive it? Can you receive it? Can you receive it? Somebody say, I receive it.
I receive it.